This is a 35mm film frame of the B-movie, but we will get to what it has to do with Oppenheimer and 70mm IMAX film in a moment. If you haven't already heard, a little movie is about to come out called Oppenheimer. Or by the time you watch this, might have come out, I don't really know. You should be hyped to see this in theaters, but not just because of the plot, because it's from Christopher Nolan, because Cillian Murphy is the star, or if you are a fan of inaudible dialogue. Thanks, Tenet. Let's pull up end card of the trailer to help better understand. If you look closely, it says, in theaters with special engagements in 70mm, 35mm, and IMAX film. That is a sentence that nobody has seen or heard in 6 years, and many thought they would never see again. Seeing a movie in 70mm IMAX film is an experience like none other, but let's get physical to help better understand. Oh yeah. This is a 35mm film frame, which is comparable to the quality and resolution of what you currently see in theaters with a digital projector. This is my baseline here. I'm not trying to start a digital versus analog argument in the comments. If you're going to, however, could you at least like and subscribe to me? Anyway, this is a 35mm film frame, super zoomed in, using a macro lens. This is a quarter here for scale if you don't know what a quarter is, and if you're not in America, this is a small circle. I don't know what else to tell you there. And here is a frame of standard non-IMAX 70mm film. As you can see that there is a size difference here, with 5 perforations on the side here, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it being 70mm wide instead of 35mm wide. If you know basic math, which I just said, it's actually 2 times wider, not taller. It is, actually, it is a little taller. Yeah, as I just said, 5 perforations. Regardless, more area in the film correlates to a larger resolution, because there's physically more data there. Now, as you can tell, 70mm then would have more than 35mm. 35mm would have more than... Damn it. Okay. 35mm would have more than 16mm. Stuff you'd find in educational documentaries, some old home videos. And of course, even larger than 8mm film. Look at that. Can you imagine the size difference between 8mm film and 70mm 5 perforation here? I'm going to do something that's going to blow your mind. Can you imagine this, but 3 of them, as in 3 70mm frames? I'm sure you're bad at imagining, so let's just get that over with here. Whoop. This right here is 3 frames of 5 perf 70mm film. As you can see, quarter's still here. Now we just have 3 of them. Outstanding. But if you rotate it on its side, whoa, we now have film rotated on its side. Hold up. If you think about it a little bit more and know about film formats, 3 frames of 70mm film just becomes 1 IMAX 70mm frame. Look at that. They literally sit on top of each other. If you can see here, instead of 5 perforations, it is now 15 perforations. You can count them. I'm not going to do that for you. Quite literally, it is just 3, like I just said here, stacked on each other. But what that results in, a massive area of resolution and image. Like, look at the size of this frame compared to my face. And when I look at it, I can see literally everything in great detail. Look at this stupid 16mm frame. Like, I can't see anything with my bare eye. This thing is literally the size of a potato. Obviously not this potato, I'm talking about like a red potato, but you get the idea. The point being of this is that seeing this in a theater is something you're not going to see anywhere else. Not on your phone, not on your TV. Let's talk about 70mm rolling loop IMAX projector. Non-laser projectors usually use this massive lamp called a short arc lamp. I promise you it is anything but short, as it literally generates light from the arc of electricity. An IMAX projector needs to be able to push enough light through the massive frames, resulting in a 15,000 watt. Yes, 1,000 watt explosive xenon short arc lamp being required, with the lamp being under an immense amount of pressure, hence the explosive nature of the bulb. Luckily, I always carry protection on me. 35mm and standard non-laser projectors usually use 2 to 5,000 watt explosive xenon bulbs, which I have this 3,000 watt one that I keep under my bed
in case I ever want to go blind.
But let me further help you comprehend why you must see this movie and any movie in 70mm IMAX film. Let's take a step back to the 35mm film strip again, where you can compare this to roughly 6K resolution. I understand most of you probably don't even care what that is. TVs these days are primarily 4K resolution. When you're playing Minecraft, you probably want it in 4K resolution. So this can do a little bit more than what the standard is now, which is great. It's fantastic. Depends on a lot of factors. Nobody cares. With that in mind, can you imagine the resolution, though, that you can get out of this IMAX strip? For reference, you can fit one 35mm frame into it about 9 times into this frame here.
Estimates say that this can be equated to a seemingly impossible 18K resolution. Yeah, you heard me right. Something that no digital sensor can come even close to.
Digital IMAX with laser can only yield around 4K still, for Christ's sake. Like, come on. That's why most people refer to it as LIMAX. It is literally a lie with the IMAX title in it. That means that when this is projected, the resolution is mind-boggling. Not to forget that this allows the film to be projected on a stupidly large, curved dome screen.
Speaking of equipment, the IMAX film still has to run at 24 frames per second, just like all other film including 35mm has to run at. The difference being that 35mm runs at only about 1.5 feet per second, something like that, every second through the projector, while IMAX runs at a staggering 5.5 feet per second. According to Alexa, that is nearly 3.3 miles per hour, which is much faster than I can run. On top of this, the film print also usually weighs around 600 pounds per movie.
According to my calculations, that is roughly 12 B-movie prints worth. Can you believe that? It weighs the equivalent of 12 B-movies. That's a lot of B-movies. Why would you not want to see a movie knowing that projectionists are literally breaking their back to present the show? If you've made it this far, congratulations. This probably means that I have kept you long enough to want to see Oppenheimer or any other IMAX movie on film. Or you left autoplay on, I don't really know. Well, that is currently a tricky one to answer. As of the time of this video, the last full feature to release on 70mm IMAX prints was Dunkirk back in 2017. That is like six years ago. I will leave some links in the description of where IMAX 70mm projection capable booths were last listed as existing, but some has since been removed, like everything else on the planet.
Here's some things to look out for. There are three types of IMAX projectors that a venue can have. There's IMAX Xenon, IMAX with laser, and of course what this video is all about, IMAX 70mm. You want to look on the advertising that the theater can run 70mm IMAX, or some might even refer to it how I was calling it earlier as 1570, which just means it's 70mm film with 15 perforations per frame. If you cannot find the showing near you on IMAX 70mm, and you want IMAX aspect ratio still, then you want to make sure the theater is showing it in laser IMAX, which is the closest to 70mm IMAX you will be able to find, with IMAX Xenon, in my opinion, not being worth it and not even the same aspect ratio. But wait! If you want to see it on 70mm film, there will be more venues showing it on 570, aka 5 perforation 70mm, which is the standard 70mm I was talking about, which still packs much more resolution than most other options. And lastly, of course, there is even going to be screenings on 35mm film, which will be still fantastic on its own. You have a lot of choices, as you can see, which is not common these days. Thanks, Nolan, for supporting film.
Let me know in the comments of any other venue that are still showing IMAX 70mm film. If you like this content and want to see more, please like and subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions about IMAX film or anything else related to projection, please ask them in the comments. Thanks and have a really good day.